strengthen their faith to get them out of their desperate setback. Would you acknowledge God as your healer, as your redeemer, and as your savior? He will do it again and again. So what is your testimony? Share it with us. Log on to www.emmanuel.tv, then click on Testimonies. Then type in your name, email address, and other details in the spaces provided. If you wish to upload a picture to attach to your testimony, click on the Browse button, select the picture from where you saved it on your computer, and click Open. Next, type in your glorious testimony in the box below, then click Submit. You can also share your testimony by calling our testimony lines. Each time God leads us through a battle, it is in our own interest to testify to His goodness as a way of thanksgiving for not allowing our adversaries to triumph over us. We look forward to hearing your testimony. The best is yet to come.
Without His Word. God's Word is His gift to mankind. When we read the Bible from Genesis to Revelation, we see that Christ and His Word are one. God's Word reflects His character and points us the way to salvation, healing, deliverance, and all of God's blessing. By looking into the Word and acting on it, we bring Jesus Christ on the scene. To bring Jesus on the scene, the living Word must live in you, grow in you, and get into your blood to gain supremacy over you. Learn to dream again as we look to God through His Word by His Spirit. Get ready to open your heart to God's Word, faith, and Spirit as we listen to what God has to say in today's Standard for Life.
Love, man, you say. It all comes down to love, yeah. Emmanuel. You may be seated. Thank you, Lord. Let's go to the book of Daniel. Daniel 3:16. These three Hebrew, Meshach, Shadrach, and Abednego, answer and said to the king, Nebuchadnezzar, we have no need to answer you in this matter. 3:16. Read after me. Meshach, Shadrach, Abednego answered and said to the king, O Nebuchadnezzar, we have no need to answer you in this matter. What are we saying here? We people of God, we do not defend ourselves because we have a defender. Tell your neighbor, you people of God, we do not need to defend ourselves because we have defender. Again, that is what three Hebrew men said. The lives of believers in both Old Testament and New Testament testify that being faithful to God does not eliminate adversity.
Encouraging Words by T.B. Joshua.
Daniel 3:16. What are we saying here? We people of God, we do not defend ourselves because we have a defender. The lives of believers in both Old Testament and New Testament testify that being faithful to God does not eliminate adversity. We should recognize that it may be a sign of being faithful to God. When our faith is tested, our endurance has a chance to grow. Adversity can also build you up and strengthen your faith.
Encouraging Words by T.B. Joshua.
Tell your neighbor, the life of believers in both Old Testament and New Testament testify that being faithful to God does not eliminate adversity. We should recognize that it may be a sign of being faithful to God. Tell your neighbor, it may be a sign of being faithful to God. When they brought them to the king, the three men said, look, we are not here to defend ourselves because we have defender. We cannot use the weapon of enemy to defend ourselves. When our faith is tested, our endurance has a chance to grow. Tell your neighbor again. Adversity can also build you up and strengthen your faith. The year of comeback. What does this mean? Mean dream again. Tell your neighbor. Dream again. I can't hear you. Again. Dream again. That is, draw greater plan in the name of Jesus. That is the meaning. Draw greater plan. This is the year to do so. Whether things are difficult or things are hard, economy made down, that is not your business, you people. Tell your neighbor, dream again. That is, draw greater plan. Some of us have been living within 4 foot ceilings when the sky is the limit. The sky is the limit. You are now living in a house you have to burn in before you enter. You want to wear your dress because of ceiling fan. Do your hand like this. Living within narrow plan and expectation when there is much room available. Tell your neighbor, dream again.
Dream again.
Yes, I'm here today to prophesy to your life.
Yeah.
As this word coming out from my mouth, drop it.
Yeah.
Just believe it. Everyone here that believe, this is word for you.
Yeah.
I prophesy to your life that God Almighty has positioned you.
Yeah.
In the name of Jesus Christ. You know, when you are positioned, you are positioned for blessing.
Amen.
When you are positioned, you are positioned for healing.
Amen.
When you are positioned, you are positioned for deliverance.
Amen.
When you are positioned, you are positioned for breakthrough.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus,
Amen.
You are positioned today.
Amen.
God has positioned you.
Amen.
God has positioned you.
Amen.
He has positioned you.
Amen.
He has positioned you.
Amen.
For victory, for victory, in the name of Jesus. Tell your neighbor, dream again. I can't hear you. I can't hear you. I prophesy, begin to live as God has created you. In the name of Jesus. Begin to live. Begin to lean, begin to talk, begin to reason, begin to walk, begin to hear as God has created you. In the name of Jesus. Tell your neighbor, dream again. I can't hear you. When you dream again, means your mess, your limitation are your opportunity in this year. Your limitation are your opportunities in this year. Your mess are your opportunity in this year. In Jesus' name. Tell viewers, your limitation,
vos limites,
your limitation,
vos limites,
are your opportunities.
Votre opportunity.
Your limitation, are your opportunities.
Sont opportunidades.
Your mess, are your opportunities.
Tu desastres,
in this new year,
en este nuevo año,
in the name of Jesus,
dans le nom de Jésus Christ.
Dream again.
Rêvez à nouveau.
Dream again.
Sueñe de nuevo.
Dream again.
Rêvez à nouveau.
When you you come against any adversity,
cuando usted viene contra cualquier adversidad,
you overcome.
Vencerá.
You overcome.
Usted vencerá.
You overcome without being hurt.
Sin ser herido.
Without being hurt or slippery. In the name of Jesus. 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 Tell your neighbor, dream again.
Sueñe de nuevo.
My name is Harry Waldhuizen. I am 51 years old. I come from Belgium and I'm a part of the leadership team of our church.
And what is the problem that's brought you to the synagogue?
Ik heb epilepsie gehad en ik ben afgekeurd in de militaire dienst voor die epilepsie na een hersenonderzoek. En de reden die de dokter zegt wat ik in mijn leven niet mocht hebben was dat ik nooit geen stress mocht hebben. Daarom ben ik afgekeurd.
He didn't do his military service because the doctor says he can never handle stress.
Maar wat ik nog wel vaak heb is dat de dokters zeggen dat ik absences heb. En als ik op mijn linkerzij zou slapen, dan heb ik altijd een toeval.
The doctor says I've got something what they called absence. And when I lay on my left side, I just have a blackout.
En ik heb 3 zware auto-ongevallen gehad in mijn leven. En de reden die men zei was ja, dat ik een blackout gehad had.
I have 3 very serious accidents, car accidents in my life. And the doctor says the reason was because of the blackouts.
Het eerste accident heb ik 6,5 maand van in het ziekenhuis gelegen. En het tweede had ik niks. En van de derde heb ik alleen een vinger die krom is.
With the first accident I was about 6.5 months in the hospital. The second one luckily nothing. And from the third one only a finger that is bent now.
So what do you hope that the Lord will do for you here in the synagogue?
Dat God mij van dat syndroom van epilepsie geneest. En dat hij mijn denken over zijn grootheid gaat veranderen.
That God will heal me from epilepsy and that God will change my understanding about his greatness and his goodness.
Is now being commanded out of Mr. Harry Waldhuizen.
In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, out! Out!
A believer is one who believes what it takes to cast out Satan.
Out! The spirit of epilepsy, out! Out! In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, out! Out! The spirit of deaf and dumb, out! In the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Prophet TB Joshua is using the authority in the mighty name of Jesus Christ to command out the spirit of epilepsy that has been tormenting this man for the past 41 years. Mr. Harry has fallen to the floor under the power of the Holy Spirit. Right now, God is controlling something out. He is moving something out, out of his spirit, soul, and body, and he is replacing it with new life. As Matthew 18 verse 18 says, whatever you bind on earth will be bound in heaven, and whatever you loose on earth will be loosed in heaven.
Remember, the first thing our Lord Jesus Christ commanded us to do when we believe is kick the devil out of our lives and the lives of others.
I'm not trying to be hard on you, but the one inside that caused the epileptic sickness.
Praise the Lord.
You're welcome to the Synagogue Church of All Nations in Lagos, Nigeria, in Jesus' name. Can you please introduce yourself for us?
Goedemiddag, ik ben Harry Wolthuizen.
Please, can you tell us your age and the country that you're coming from?
Ik ben 54 jaar en ik kom uit België vandaan.
I am 54 years of age and I live in Belgium.
What is the problem that brought you to the synagogue?
Ik ben met mijn voorganger naar de Church of All Nations gekomen. Ik keek de dingen een klein beetje. En toen ze vroegen welke ziekte dat ik had, moest ik eerlijk bekennen dat ik nog altijd epilepsie had.
I came here on the invitation of my pastor of the church and I told her that I had epilepsy.
And for how long had you been suffering from the problem of epilepsy?
Epilepsie is in onze familie een familieafwijking, want je hebt sommige epilepsies die erfelijk zijn en andere niet. En ik had de erfelijke vorm vanaf mijn jeugd, van geboorte af aan. Want ik heb zelfs een tante die aan een epilepsieaanval gestorven is.
I have this epilepsy since I was born as a defect. It runs in the family. And an aunt of mine died during a seizure.
So can you tell us, how did the epilepsy affect your own life? Your physical life, your everyday activities?
Ik mocht heel veel dingen niet doen. Ik mocht niet zwemmen. Ik mocht officieel niet met een auto rijden. En alles wat gevaarlijk was, mocht ik niet doen.
I was not allowed to swim. And later on, I was not allowed to drive a car.
Did you suffer any attacks, any seizures as a result of the epilepsy?
Het ergste heb ik gehad dat ik op één dag 8 toevallen gekregen heb. Minstens 2 keer gehad dat ik een toeval kreeg met een zwaar auto-accident. Eentje, het laatste was in het voorjaar van 2000. Heb ik op de ring van Antwerpen een zwaar auto-accident gehad waar ik over 6 baanvakken heen gevlogen ben. En toen tegen een grote betonnen muur de auto totaal los gekregen terwijl het een aanval was.
When I was younger, in 1963, there was one day that I had 8 seizures on the same day. It was a terrible day. But at least 2 times car accidents were due to the epilepsy. The last one was a terrible accident. It happened in June 2000 on the highway around the city Antwerp in Belgium. And my car collapsed and it bounced back over 6 lanes and another piece of grass and another 2 lanes. Cars did not bump into my car, but the end was a big wall. And the doctors were very worried about me. They thought it was a heart attack. And then later on it seemed to be epilepsy, a seizure, because his tongue was bitten and black.
Wow, so we can see that this is a very serious disease in your life. Can you tell us, is there any other job that you couldn't perform because of the epilepsy?
Ik had sommige momenten dat ik totaal geen kracht meer had. Ik had heel vaak zware hoofdpijn en was dan erg geïrriteerd, was onaangenaam voor de omgeving, voor mijn vrouw en kinderen. Dus ook karakterieel was er heel veel wat destructie gegeven had.
I often felt I had no power and I felt very sleepy. At very important moments I could fall asleep, even at the steer wheel of the car. And I felt irritated and angry, frustrated, so I was not so easy to be with people, for my wife and children.
Okay, so we see a medical report with you. Can you please explain this report for us?
Dit is het rapport, een van de rapporten, maar dat is van de militaire dienst, waar ze na hersenonderzoeken duidelijk gezien hebben dat er afwijkingen waren op het EEG-onderzoek. En als gevolg daarvan ben ik ook afgekeurd voor militaire dienst, want er staat erop, ik ben een man met gebreken, stond erop.
This paper is the check-up of the military service. In Holland, in that time, they called you in the military service at a certain age, and they did a checkup, and because of the epilepsy and the abnormal EEG, that is an examination of your brain with electric wires, they could not use him, and they did not want him to be in the military service. And the last piece of the book there is they say he has defects, gebreken.
Okay, we see another medical report with you. Can you please explain it in further detail for us?
This is in the middle of the medical report, and you can see the word epilepsy on this, and his name. This is the most important thing.
Okay, so we see that you came to the synagogue Church of All Nations and stood in prayer line and received prayer from the man of God, Prophet T.B. Joshua. Can you please tell us, what did you experience as the man of God was praying for you?
Ik moet zeggen van, ik was erg bang om te gaan vallen. En ik had me verzet en ik had mijn voeten zo gezet dat ik niet zou kunnen vallen.
I was very afraid to fall on the floor. Harry says I put my legs wide spread out to be firm on the ground.
En ik dacht, met mijn gewicht lukt hem dat toch nooit niet. Dus ik stond zo, ik denk, dat lukt hem dus nooit.
I thought with my weight, brother Joshua cannot get me on the floor.
En toen kwam hij bij hem en hij strekte zijn hand af. En ik ervaarde zo'n kracht en ja, daar ging ik.
Brother Joshua took out his hand and I experienced the power and I went down.
And how did you feel immediately after the prayer of Prophet T.B. Joshua?
Oh, dat was ongelooflijk. Die avond heb ik, en ik kan niet dansen, verschillende uren met heel wat dames hier ongelooflijk gedanst.
I was so happy, I cannot describe it. I danced almost the whole night
after the prayer. How was your life, your everyday activities, your mental state? How are you?
Er is ongelooflijk veel veranderd, maar ook vooral karakterieel is er heel veel veranderd.
Many things are changed and the most important thing is that my character changed.
Amen. Hallelujah.
Ik geloof dat een demon je karakter kan misvormen. Want ik heb het tegenovergestelde nu ervaren.
I know now that such an evil spirit can damage your character. And now I'm so happy because now I experience the liberty of God.
Praise the Lord. Have you gone back to the doctors since you've been healed?
Toen ik in België kwam, heb ik het aan onze kinderen verteld, aan mijn secretaresse op het werk verteld, aan mijn vrouw verteld. En toen ben ik naar de kliniek gegaan en hebben ze een hele dag onderzoeken gedaan. En de dokter wilde daar niet geloven dat ik ooit epilepsie gehad had, want hij zegt, ik vind niets meer.
Praise the Lord!
When I came back, I told my children that I was healed, and my wife and the secretary in the office. And later on, I went to a hospital, and they did a brain examination for a whole day, an all nervous system examination. And the doctor there said to me, I don't believe that you ever had epilepsy, because everything is normal.
Amen. Let's clap for Jesus.
Hier heb ik het rapport van die dokter in België, waar duidelijk in staat dat ten eerste ik heb wel hersenen, maar geen epilepsie meer.
This is the report of the doctor in Belgium after the healing in, I thought, February or so in 2001.
Yeah.
In this medical report, the doctor says here that the epilepsy started from about 7 years of age. That it was a family problem of the side of the father's family. Let me see. There's more. And then they start the brain checkup, and here they say that the brains are good structured. You need that. And then another page. They are talking about normal brain activity, and you have electric waves in your brain, and they don't go out of the border that is permitted. I think that epilepsy patients, they have, it goes in like that. And for him it is normal now, the waves are normal.
Praise the Lord. So before you came to the synagogue, the doctors confirmed you to have epilepsy. But after the prayer of the anointed man of God, Prophet T.B. Joshua, you went back to the doctors, and the doctors again confirmed you to be free from the problem of epilepsy. Is this correct?
Yes.
Yes, that's correct.
Amen. Let's clap for Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. So you received your healing in the year 2000, and this is the year 2004. So for the last 4 years, you have been completely free of the problem of epilepsy. We thank God for the healing He has performed in your life. So now that you've been healed, can you please tell us, what is your promise to God Almighty?
Mijn belofte aan God is dat ik Hem met mijn hele hart wil dienen en dat ik niet meer wil zondigen.
My promise to God is I want to serve Him with whole of my heart and not sin again, never anymore.
Amen.
My name is Marinella Cordero Cimenti. I'm 32 years old. I'm from Mozambique. I stay in Zimbabwe. The problem which brought me here at Synagogue Church of All Nations is I'm addicted on ice cube and mincemeat, I'm addicted on eating ice cube, mincemeat, and evil attacks.
Let us take a closer look at her addiction. Marinella holds up a bag of mint flavor sweets and a tub of ice cubes. She has been addicted to eating these for the past 5 years. Demonstrating her normal habit of how she consumes them. Taking great spoonfuls at a time before hurriedly munching them down like potatoes. A look inside her mouth reveals the crushed cube of ice gradually melting away as she eats on. She takes spoonful after spoonful, evidently having great appetite for ice. After showing how voraciously she consumes ice cubes, Marinella from Zimbabwe begins to unwrap the mint flavor sweets that she is also addicted to eating. She pours some of the mints out on the little tray lid before she starts eating them one by one. Before she has even finished chewing one of the sweets, another one joins it inside her mouth. And as she demonstrates, before long, she has a whole mouthful of mangoed sweets, which she continues to chew on. Almost finished, she shows how she has crunched the sweets up before getting ready to swallow them. This is the addiction she has brought to the Synagogue Church of All Nations.
They all start one day in 2006 when my cousin was eating ice cube. So the voice inside me was telling me I should eat. Then I start to eat up to now. I never stop it. I try to stop on my own and I couldn't. I eat like a normal food. I can put in the plate. I've been eating all this over past five years. And one day I dreamed a man coming in to me and he gave me one mint sweet. Since that time I cannot survive without mint sweet. I've been eating all the time. Like from yesterday to today I ate 100. I finished this packet. I didn't eat today all day because I was busy eating mincemeat. And all these problems create me heart burning, and I'm short of blood, and I feel pain all over my body because I don't eat normal food always. I always eat mincemeat. So I saw many people be delivered at Emmanuel TV. That's what make me coming here for deliverance. Even right now, I'm so irritated. I'm feeling, I'm desperate. I want eyes.
Come. Okay, bring your camera. Let them see how burn it is. So at this level now, even if you decided to off it, you may not know. But by the time you face this sister, you are from where?
South Africa.
By the time you face this sister, you will know that... oh wow, what I see, transformation, which now become a great one, I'm seeing now in your life. So now, you can put it down, go there and stretch your hand. Just stretch your hand, I know you have not done it before, but you go and do it. Ah, look at the way my brother works.
In the name of Jesus Christ, be delivered now.
The man stretches forth his hand in the name of Jesus Christ. You can see the lady is not at ease with herself as she moves around and throws her bangle and necklace aggressively on the ground. She then removes her shoes as she undergoes deliverance in the power of the Holy Spirit.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
She scratches her head as the fire of the Holy Ghost consumes every atom of Satan in her life that is the cause of her addiction to eating ice cubes and sweets. She tries desperately to escape.
Come back!
On your knee, say!
On your knee!
In front of you!
On your knees in front of people! On your knees! In the name of Jesus, on your knees!
No.
On your knees in the name of Jesus!
No, no!
On your knees!
Oh, no!
On your knees!
No,
in the name of Jesus!
No, no, no!
In the name of Jesus Christ!
Who are you? I'm older than you!
On your knees!
You're
not older than Jesus Christ! On your knees! On your knees! In the name of Jesus Christ, on your knees! Holy Spirit, fire! You are free.
What happened? Why throw everything away?
Father, it was burned all over.
So, brother, that is it.
I've got a task.
You say he has got tasks.
Can see it.
An assignment.
An assignment.
Don't go out from church.
Marinella worriedly holds the spoon with an ice cube on it, shaken before she can bring herself to put it in her mouth. She tries to chew it as she once could, but her body reacts as she is forced to spit the ice out. A glorious trophy of the gospel victory, Marinella is now delivered from her addiction of eating ice cubes and mincemeat. She eats a sumptuous meal of chicken and rice. Glory be to God.
Emmanuel, first I want to thank God to bless the world with a wonderful man of God, T.B. Joshua, a wiser man in his ministry. My name is Marinella Cordero Cimenta. I'm from Mozambique. The problem which brought me here at Synagogue Church of All Nations, I was addicted on eating ice cube, mint sweets, and evil attacks. They all started when I saw my cousin on 2006 eating ice cube. So the evil spirit which was inside me was telling me to start to eat. Then I start to eat that ice cube. I couldn't stop it. I've been eating all the place I go. I've been searching for ice cube. Sometimes I'll pass through restaurants. I'll pretend like I want water. Then I'll ask them to put little water and a lot of ice. I've been eating ice cube like a normal food. Ice cubes was my best food. And again, one day, I dreamed a dead man coming to me. and he gave me mint sweets, and I ate it. Since that time, I couldn't stop it. I've been eating mint sweet for over 5 past years or so. Wherever I go, I'll take mint sweets. I could eat 100 to 150 years mint sweet a pack a day. Then I've seen a lot of wonders God has been doing through Emmanuel TV. Then we decide to come here at Synagogue Church of All Nations. We came here by the grace of God. I've been touched by God and I've delivered on 31st December. After my deliverance, on Monday, I dreamed it like I was in a party with a lot of people around, old friends from Angola. Then they prepared a nice food for me in the plate. Then the guy came and he gave me the food. I ordered the food. Then the man of God, TB Joshua, came and pushed the food on Monday in the dream. Then he said, no, he took the food, he threw it. Then he said, no, you are not belong to this world. You don't have to eat this. You are delivered. This is arena of liberty. Then I get angry. I said, like, man of God, give me, I want my food. And he says, no, you are delivered forever. Then I wake up. Since my deliverance, I don't hear that voice talk to me anymore. I don't feel like it's mincemeat. Even that desire for ice cube just left like that. And I went to the restaurant. They served me drink. They put ice. I just look at ice and I said, no, I don't want. I just want a simple drink without ice. Due to this old problem, I used to suffer from short of blood. I used to faint all over. I used to dream a man give me food. I used to dream a man sleep with me. I've been going to many churches searching for solutions. I've been going to different witch doctors, herbalists, spiritualists, trying to remove these spirits, but no one managed to do it. Since then, I'm feel fresh, I'm feel new, I'm feel pretty. I used to see myself ugly and old. Since after my delivery, I'm now new person. I change. I can even run all over. I don't have short of blood anymore. I thank Jesus for all what he did for me. I want advice viewers all over the world to worship God, to follow Jesus, to wait for good times. And I want to tell viewers all over the world, Jesus is alive.
Thank you. Thank you.
My name is Opuwari Goodhead. The woman standing by my side, she's my wife. Her name is Biobele Opuwari Goodhead. I'm a native of Calabar, River State. What brought me is this church, Snowball Church of All Nations. My wife has been having miscarriage and bleeding for 5 years. We have been going to a hospital, one after another, that is not avail. Went to some native, where they give us drugs, we look, there is no avail. We have been watching Emmanuel TV, we have been seeing how God is using this church to help people. Now, we came here, there was a man that sit on the wheelchair that very day. The man of God used the water to sprinkle the man's leg, and the man got up and walked. When my wife was standing up to glorify God, you know, somebody tapped her that, madam, look at your back. You are bleeding. When I turn, I see my wife. You know, I almost cry. I feel embarrassed. Anywhere we go, that's how what we are facing. For a number of years, that Sunday, the man of God ministered the fruit of the water. After service, we went to where we lodge. I now took the water. This is the water. I pray and I put into her mouth. She take it in. Because she said she believed that since her leg stepped into this church, God that did for that woman will do for her. That's the belief she came with, and that faith. So we went to the hotel room, I spray it, and I also take it. That very night, she told me that, look, inside her tummy, she's feeling some strange, you know, sign, something's moving inside her stomach. When she went into the toilet, and she said that what she's passing out from her private part was very black, and the odor is very bad, which she cannot perceive. I was shocked when I see what is going to happen to my wife. I said, God of TB Joshua has done it. I believe that what I came here for, God has answered my prayer. As soon as she took the water, when those things passed out from my prayer part, immediately that bleeding stopped. The next thing, then both of us sleep as husband and wife. After 2-3 weeks later, she said she cannot menstruate again. It's like she's carrying baby. Now you can see her, she's pregnant. Our names are Mr. and Ms. Opuwari Goodhead. We're native of Calabari in River State. What brought us to the United Church of All Nations is barrenness. I have been bleeding. I've been going to places, no avail, hospitals. Sometimes when we are on the way going to hospital to look for way out from our problem, she will bleed and people will try to help us, and I go to places, there's no solution. So we came to the synagogue of our nation. When we came, and the church, we sit at the end, back there. My wife bleed in the church. Then one of the usher take my wife to the bathroom and clean her up. There was a man that sit down in the wheelchair. I saw that 23rd May, 2010. That man increased my faith. I believe that this place is the last bus stop. I've been going to places, no avail. But when I come to Synagogue Church of All Nations, I see that the Spirit of God dwells in this church. So when I'm opportunity to have my anointing water, then after service, I went to my hotel room. I applied it with faith because I believe that the man of God said that it's all about faith. Whatever thing you're asking for God, have the faith. Just believe in God. Leave the rest. God will do it for you. When I applied anointing water, after some minutes, I have to admit that she's feeling some strange sign in her body, in her system. After some time, she went to toilet. What she passed out was very bad, smellish, so ugly. I said, wow, God, this is my turn. God of synagogue has answered me. After she passed out what she passed out that night, when we get back to Port Harcourt, when I meet as husband and wife, then she took in. So she has delivered today. You can see she has delivered.
Emmanuel, I'm advising the viewers, they should hold God strong and they should have patience and wait on the Lord. The Lord that did it for me will also do it for them in Jesus' name.
Right now, open your lips and begin to give thanks to God for positioning you. Give thanks to God for positioning you.
On veut voler et rendre grâce à Dieu de nous avoir positionné.
Continue dando gracias a Dios por haberlo posicionado.
Give thanks to Him for positioning you.
Rendez grâce à Dieu de nous avoir positionné.
Continue dando gracias a Dios por haberlo posicionado.
In Jesus Christ's name we pray. Amen. Father, we thank you for positioning us. Now, you have been positioned. Whatever you ask God is just within you, before you, beside you, behind you. Your past is over. Now God has positioned you. Begin to receive your deliverance. Receive your deliverance. Receive your deliverance. Receive your deliverance.
Receive your deliverance.
Now you are to live as God has created you. Whatever Satan might have used to connect you, begin to disconnect yourself. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, whatever chain
que soient les chaînes.
Demon, but I'm used to connect anyone here.
Que les démons utilisés pour connecter
quelqu'un ici. To connect your business. To connect your head.
Pour connecter vos affaires.
To connect your life. To connect your career.
Connecter votre vie, votre carrière.
In the name of Jesus.
Dans le nom de Jésus-Christ.
In the name of Jesus.
Connectez votre destinée.
Be loose. Be loose.
Soyez libérés.
Be loose.
Soyez libérés.
Keep up. Be loose. Be loose. You give up. I come against you. I come against you. In the name of Jesus. I come against you. In the name of Jesus. I come against you. In the name of Jesus. I come against you. In the name of Jesus. You repeat after me. Say, you demon, I come against you in the name of Jesus. You demon, I come against you in the name of Jesus. Out of my way, out of my life, prayer.
Continue de prier et dis de toi, démon, je viens contre toi. Toi, Satan, je viens contre toi. Sors de ma vie dans le nom de Jésus-Christ. Prie.
Continue revocando a todo espíritu impuro. Sal de mi vida, sal de mi camino en el nombre poderoso de Jesucristo.
In the mighty name of Jesus. Right now, your conscience now, whatever within you, be delivered in the name of Jesus. Be delivered in the name of Jesus.
Soyez délivré dans le nom de Jésus.
Stretch your hand and agree with me. Say, I agree with you.
Dis, je suis d'accord avec toi.
Say, you TB Joshua. I agree with you. In the name of Jesus.
Je suis d'accord avec toi.
In the name of Jesus. Say, TB Joshua.
TB Joshua.
I agree with you.
Je suis d'accord avec toi.
In the name of Jesus. Say, TB Joshua. I agree with you. In the name of Jesus. Say, TB
Joshua. TB
Joshua. I agree with you.
En el nombre de Jesús. En el nombre de Jesús.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Open your lips now and begin to confess whom you are now. I'm delivered. I'm delivered. Defeat and failures.
La défaite et l'échec.
Actions of the past.
Sur les choses du passé.
I'm justified.
Je suis justifié.
I'm justified. I'm no longer condemned.
Je suis plus sous la condamnation.
Open your lips and begin to confess this.
Ouvrez vos lèvres et continuez de confesser ces choses. Dans le nom de Jésus.
Give thanks to God. Give thanks to God. Give thanks to God. Viewers at home.
Téléspectateurs.
Agree with me.
Soyez en accord avec moi.
Say, I agree with TB Joshua.
Je suis en accord avec TB Joshua.
In the name of Jesus.
Je suis d'accord avec TB Joshua.
Whatever.
Dans le nom de Jésus.
Satan might have used.
Et parce que Satan a utilisé.
To connect me.
Pour me connecter.
With himself.
À lui-même.
Be loose.
In the name of
Jesus.
Be loose.
Pas délié.
In the name of Jesus. You have released yourself from the hands of Satan. You can bless your business, bless your home, bless your marital life, bless everything that has to do with you.
Bendiga su esposo, bendiga su esposa, bendiga sus hijos, su hogar, su familia, todo lo que tiene que ver con usted. Bendígalo en el nombre de Jesús.
Thank you, Lord. As from today, write it down. Your limitation are your opportunities. Tell your neighbor, your limitation
and
your opportunity.
Sur votre opportunité.
Tell your neighbor once again.
Su limitación es su oportunidad.
Tell your neighbor again.
Vos limites sont votre opportunité.
Just step out and say, my limitation are my opportunities. In Jesus' name. Begin to step your leg and say, my limitation. Opportunity. limitation and my opportunity. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. If you have not known the Lord, say after me, Lord Jesus.
Seigneur Jésus.
Sinner.
Jesus.
Come into my heart.
Viens dans mon cœur.
Wash me with your precious blood.
Lave-moi dans ton sang précieux.
Save my soul today.
Sauve mon âme aujourd'hui.
My Savior.
Mon Sauveur.
My Savior.
Mon Sauveur.
My Redeemer.
Mon Rédempteur.
My Healer.
Mon Guérisseur.
Thank you for my salvation.
Merci pour mon salut.
Merci pour ma salvation.
In Jesus Christ's name.
Dans le nom de Jésus-Christ.
Changing nations, changing the world.
Emmanuel, viewers all over the world, whatever medium you are using to view us right now with a handshake, good morning. I say good morning once again. The year 2016.